Let us continue with chapter 1, The Living World. Molecular taxonomical tools. So when you say molecular taxonomical tools, we are going to speak about the molecular level. That is, we are going to speak about the DNA, the molecules that are making up the organisms. So these tools are very useful in recognizing the characteristic feature of the living organisms. So the following methods are being used for the taxonomical classification. So let us see what are those methods. DNA barcoding, DNA hybridization, DNA fingerprinting, restriction fragment length polymorphism analysis, polymerase chain reaction sequencing. So these are some of the methods which are used as the taxonomical tools to identify the characteristic features of the living organisms in order to classify them into different groups. DNA barcoding. You might be knowing the term barcoding. They are some coded forms which are read with the help of the machines. So here we are going to see about the DNA barcoding. So these are short genetic marker in an organism's DNA to identify it as belonging to a particular species. So the DNA consists of some short genetic markers which helps us to identify the particular species. DNA hybridization. When you say DNA hybridization, formation of hybrid DNAs. In order to measure the degree of genetic similarities among the pool of DNA sequences. So, DNA hybridization is a method of making hybrid DNAs in order to measure the degree of genetic similarities from the group of DNA sequences. Then comes the DNA fingerprinting. This helps us to identify an individual from the sample of DNA by looking at unique patterns in their DNA. So there are some unique patterns in the DNA which helps us to identify the individuals. Restriction fragment length polymorphism analysis, RFLP. So this refers to the differences in the homologous DNA sequences that can be detected by the presence of fragments of different lengths after digestion of the DNA samples. So when the DNA samples are made to digest, we get some DNA fragments of different lengths. So by comparing the homologous DNA of different lengths, we can find out the characteristic features. So here is the experiment performed to detect the presence of fragments of different lengths. So blood stains are taken. From the blood stains, the DNA is extracted from the blood cells and the restriction enzymes cleaves the DNA. Restriction enzymes are the enzymes which cut the DNA into small pieces. These small pieces are laid down. The fragments of DNA are separated by the electrophoresis method and they are laid down on a glass slide. Now these transfer of DNA fragment to a membrane is made. Later on, they are subjected to the radioactive DNA probe that binds to the specific DNA. Now we get the membranes washed, okay, from the excess of probe. DNAs are removed, then they are subjected to the x-ray. X-rays are taken and we get those DNA on the x-ray sheets, and with that we can compare the homologous chromosomes. Is that clear? Of different lengths, and we can detect the characteristic features. We can compare the characteristic features of the organisms. Polymerase chain reaction, PCR sequencing. Clear? This is to amplify a specific gene or a portion of a gene and are used as taxonomical tool. Now this method PCR is nothing but to make a number of copies of the DNA. So DNA is nothing but a part of the gene. Clear? And this amplified form of the DNA helps us to study about the characteristic features of the different organisms. So here they are showing the method of amplification. Okay. Automated species identification tool is the next tool. It is called to be the cyber tool. So it consists of cyber tools, for example, DALIS, ALIS, ABIS, SPIDA, DrawWing, etc. So these are some of the cyber tools. Now when you come to the full forms of these, ALIS refers to Automated Leafhopper Identification System. DALIS refers to Digital Automated Identification System. ABIS refers to Automatic Bee Identification System. SPIDA refers to Species Identification Automatically. DrawWing, Honeybee Wing Identification. So these are some of the cyber tools which are used as the taxonomical tools. Neotaxonomical tools. This is based on electron microscopy images to study the molecular structures of cell organelles. If you feel to study the structures of the cell organelles, we can refer the electron microscopic images. So this is new method of taxonomical tool. Ethology of taxonomical tool. When you come to the ethology, it is based on the behavior of the organisms. We can classify them into different groups. For example, based on the sound of birds, based on the bioluminescence. Bioluminescence refers to the glowing of the body of the organism. Some of the animals glow at night. So based on the emission of light, we can classify them into different groups. E-taxonomic resources. INOTAXA is an electronic resource for digital images and description about the species, which was developed by Natural History Museum, London. So Inotaxa means integrated open taxonomic access. Clear? So it's an electronic resource for digital images, and it was developed by the Natural History Museum, London. Is that clear? These tools can act as the taxonomic tools, helps us to classify the animals. Let us recap. So in today's topic, we came across nomenclature. Nomenclature refers to the naming of organisms, and they are of two types: binomial nomenclature and trinomial nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature refers to naming organism with two scientific names. Trinomial refers to naming the animals with three scientific names. The next one, we came across species. So species is referred to as a basic unit of classification, and some of the scientists like John Ray, Carolus Linnaeus and Charles Darwin, they were the ones to study about the species in detail. Next, we came across tools to study taxonomy. Under tools to study taxonomy, there are some classical taxonomical tools like the museum, zoological park, marine parks, printed taxonomical tools. So these tools are considered to be the classical tools, or in olden days, people used to refer these places for classifying the animals. Later on, due to the technological advancement, new tools like molecular tools have developed. So the classical tools are now replaced by the molecular tools. So they are very accurate. Clear? So the molecular tools like DNA barcoding, DNA hybridization, DNA fingerprinting, and the restriction fragment length polymorphism analysis, and PCR, polymerase chain reaction. So these are considered to be the molecular taxonomical tools. Next, we came across the automated species identification tool. So In order to identify species, we have some cyber tools like DAISY, ALIS, ABIS, SPIDA, and Drawing. The other cyber tools are the neotaxonomical tool, which depends on the electron microscopic image, ethology of taxonomical tool that refers to the behavioral changes, behavioral pattern of the organism, e-taxonomic resources, the resources that we get from the computers or in the form of digital images, the electronic resources that we obtain as the digital images, which gives us the description about the species. So all these things are very useful tools which helps us to classify the animals. So with that, we finish with this chapter 1, the living world. Clear, children? And we continue with a new topic in the next class. Thank you, children.